Hey everyone, Casey here from Clientric. In today's tutorial, we're going to be diving into Zoho Bookings and how you can go about setting up your consultations. So let's log in and we'll see you there. All right, now that we're logged in, we're going to go ahead and look at that booking page that we created last time we didn't have enough time to get to. So if we come over to the settings tab here, we can go to the consultations and we can see the introduction meeting that we created first in the last tutorial. Now in here, we have a bunch of more settings that the workspace had in it as well, very similar, but these are now specific to the consultation. So the consultation is specific to that meeting type. You could have, you know, 1,000 different consultations in here if you really wanted to, and they could each have their own settings. So it's important to come through and just make sure it all looks good. So let's look at the consultant information first. So the name of the consultation is introduction. We set that up before. It's allocated to the workspace Clientric. It's a consultation type of one-on-one. It has a reference color of this. This really just means it's this color. You can color code them for different departments if you so chose, or you could set it up in a different way. Color coding can be good if you have multiple in the same area. We also have a duration of 30 minutes. Price is free and the buffer time is 15 minutes. So remember when we set this up, we can actually go through and edit here too. So we could say, you know what? We actually want this to be 45 minutes and then we still want a buffer time of 15 minutes, which means it's gonna book for a full hour in your calendar and it's gonna book for 45 minutes in the other individual's calendar that's booking it. Visibility here is public and the status is active. If you select it to inactive, no one's gonna be able to see this. No one's gonna be able to go to it. No one's gonna be able to do anything with this. If you set it to private, this means that only you are going to be able to send this to people. They are not going to be able to go through your workspace, find this type of consultation. This is only private, so that specific link will be sent to someone and they'll only be able to access it. Now, we have the ability to change the consultants that are assigned to this. Again, if you just click up here in the edit, you can go through and add a new consultant. It's going to take you to the Zoho One panel if you don't have anyone else already in the Zoho Bookings page. You can add in someone here. So it's allowing you to choose a user to add them to your system. So this, we don't have any other users in our system because this is a demo account. But if you were to add someone else to it, you would choose a user here. Let's say user two, a demo2.clientric.co. Then you could choose which services. Maybe I want to assign them to the introduction services with a role of, you know, admin. That would be an easy way to add someone to this to make sure that they can access all of that information and be allowed to, you know, be a part of that meeting type. So now that that's finished, you also have the ability to remove individuals. So if you go over the profile, you can select this X right here, and that will remove them from that consultation. So you're good to go there. Or you can just press cancel and be done with it all. So there's a little info button here, which has a knowledge base in it. Always feel free to utilize that as well. Now, consultation availability. This is where we've talked before about the available date range. So the consultation will be available for bookings for an indefinite period of time. We do have the ability to set up how long this is going to last for. Maybe you're doing a time-sensitive meeting and this is only for the month of August that you want to run. This is where you'd go to set that up. So we're going to cancel out of here. And then you also have available time. So based on consultant availability. So booking slots will be available based on a consultant's availability. This means you have the ability to choose based off the consultant's availability and their schedule. So in one of the settings here, we're going to dive into that in the future, but you have the ability to set the consultant's schedule where they can choose when they want to book meetings. Maybe they only want to book meetings between 9 a.m. and 12 p.m., no other time. So that was based on the consultant availability. No other times would be available for anyone to book a meeting with the consultant. You also have the ability to set a custom time here, and you can set up custom time slots for this individual meeting type. So you can, whatever time zone you're in, you can set it. And let's say you wanted to have some on, let's see if I can get out of this, on Sunday for whatever reason. Maybe Sunday is your Monday, and you want to book a lot of meetings there. You could leave that open for people to book meetings with you. You can change different times. So 1 a.m. or let's say 1 p.m. to 4 p.m., just like I was talking about before. You would be allowed to set that for specific days for these individuals to only book this type of meeting within. You can also add special availability. So you can offer consultations on weekends or clock extra work hours, then add them here and open additional slots. So on specific days, if you have time available, let's say you had
this weekend available. You could select some time available then, and you can just click save and you're ready to be booking meetings in there as well. Now you also have the ability to add unavailability. So if you were to come in here, you could add time off or block time depending on what days and what times you need. So you can say, I'm actually not available this week because I am on vacation. If, however, you are able to select your vacation period in your calendar, and your calendar is also connected to this, you will be, you won't be able to have a meeting booked within there because the meeting is already on that calendar. So this is another way to do this, but if you're already doing it another way through the calendar, which again, we're going to talk about more in the future, then you don't need to worry about this, but this is an option for availability as well. So we're going to get out of here and go to notifications. Again, like the workspace, we can set up custom notifications. So for consultants, for customers, coming into here, setting up these different customized email notifications, we can set that up with SMS. We can also set that up. For preferences, we have the ability here to let customers select a consultant or not. This would just be a round robin, kind of randomly decided who gets what meeting. If they allow them to be decided, then you can set that up and they can choose. And again, we have the ability to set the scheduling interval. So every 15 minutes, every half hour, every hour, this is how often someone can book a meeting with you. Time zone presets, booking confirmation page. All of this is very similar to the workspace page that you're now should now be familiar with. And then you have minimum booking notice, maximum booking notice. Again, this is a much more granular level on this specific consultation. So you could have higher level rules on the workspace, and then you could go more granular as you went down into each booking if you really wanted to. Your booking form here, you can select which fields you want, and the booking URL, you can select this again to be whatever you want, and you can embed it as a widget. So all of this is very similar to the way that the workspace was that we looked through last tutorial. So be sure to reference that if you are unsure what to do or how to add in different fields. You can add in different fields through all these different options, a radio button options, put that in there, make it mandatory, make it not mandatory, and you can continue to add in different fields. The booking URL, again, you just customize and change to whatever you want. So if I put an uppercase in here, it's going to make it as a lowercase. So it doesn't really matter what you put in. And that is it for the consultation overview here of this introduction meeting type. Again, it's a lot more granular compared to the workspace. You can set up different rules. I hope you can start to see the complexity that is involved in a bookings product like this that Zoho does offer. There is a lot to it. It's not quite as user-friendly as, let's say, Acuity or Calendly, but it does have a lot of power to it if you're willing to set it up properly. So it does take a little bit of time to go through, but once it's done, you're set. Everything is looking good within your business, and I highly recommend you go through. And if you have Zoho Bookings or if you're looking to implement it, you think about how you want to structure it, and then you start implementing it from there. As always, please be sure to follow along, subscribe to our channel, and if you've gotten any value out of this at all, please do like and comment down below. It helps us reach a bigger audience like yourself who is trying to learn Zoho Bookings. It's a big tool. There's not a lot of information out there, so we want to get this out there to as many people as possible. Thanks for your time, and we'll see you in the next one.